And now, ladies and gentlemen, the processional will begin. Left, entering from the northwest corner of Alumni Park, are incoming students from the USC Sol Price School of Public Policy, the USC Gould School of Law, the USC Leventhal School of Accounting, the USC Gloria Kaufman School of Dance, the USC Roski School of Art and Design, the USC School of Dramatic Arts, the USC Iovine and Young Academy, the USC Thornton School of Music, the USC Rosier School of Education, the USC Bovard College, the USC Leonard Davis School of Gerontology, the Keck School of Medicine of USC, and the Herman Ostrow School of Dentistry of USC. Also to your left, entering in three columns from the northwest corner, are incoming students from the USC Viterbi School of Engineering, entering to your right from the northeast corner of the park are incoming students from the USC School of Cinematic Arts, the USC Suzanne Dworak Peck School of Social Work, the USC Annenberg School for Communication and Journalism, the USC School of Architecture, and the USC School of Pharmacy. Also to your right, entering in four columns from the southeast corner of Alumni Park, are incoming students from the USC Dornsife College of Letters, Arts, and Sciences, and the USC Marshall School of Business. your left, entering from the northwest corner of Alumni Park, are incoming students from the USC Sol Price School of Public Policy, the USC Gould School of Law, the USC Leventhal School of Accounting, the USC Gloria Kaufman School of Dance, the USC Roski School of Art and Design, the USC School of Dramatic Arts, the USC Iovine and Young Academy, the USC Thornton School of Music, the USC Rosier School of Education, the USC Bovard College, the USC Leonard Davis School of Gerontology, the Keck School of Medicine of USC, and the Herman Ostro School of Dentistry of USC. Also to your left, entering in three columns from the northwest corner, are incoming students from the USC Viterbi School of Engineering, entering to your right, from the northeast corner of the park, are incoming students from the USC School of Cinematic Arts, the USC Suzanne Dworak Peck School of Social Work, the USC Annenberg School for Communication and Journalism, the USC School of Architecture, and the USC School of Pharmacy. Also to your right, entering in four columns from the southeast corner of Alumni Park, are incoming students from the USC Doornzijf College of Letters, Arts, and Sciences, and the USC Marshall School of Business. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the procession continues from the front steps of Bovard Administration Building. Heraldic flags representing the university's degree-granting academic units and carried by students from those units are making their way to the center of Alumni Park. Following the flag bearers are representatives of the university's residential faculty who live on campus and serve as mentors to students in USC's residential colleges. Marching columns also include representatives of the staff of the Division of Student Affairs and the Division of Enrollment Services. Next in the procession are faculty representatives from each of the university's academic units. All of USC's faculty and staff are dedicated to helping our students thrive and helping them learn how to make a difference in the world. The platform party will now approach from Bovard Administration Building. One column is led by the president of the faculty, Professor Tracy Tambasia, who is carrying the silver university mace. The second column is led by Winston Crisp, the university's vice president for student affairs. The procession begins with the deans of USC's schools and academic units, followed by the senior officers of the university and the university trustees in their cardinal gowns of office. The deans in the procession include Dean Amber Miller, the USC Dana and David Dornzive College of Letters, Arts, and Sciences, founded in 1880. Dean Catherine Quinlan, the USC Libraries, 1880. Dean Haven Lynn Kirk, the USC Roski School of Art and Design, 1883. Dean Robert Cudietta, the USC Thornton School of Music, 1884. Interim Dean Stephen Shapiro, the Keck School of Medicine of USC, 1885. Dean Andrew Guzman, the USC Gould School of Law, 1896. Dean Avishai Sadan, the Herman Ostro School of Dentistry of USC, 1897. Associate Dean of Undergraduate Education and Professor of Clinical Pharmacy, Daryl Davies, the USC School of Pharmacy, 1905. Dean Yanis Yortsos, the USC Viterbi School of Engineering, 1905. Dean Pedro Noguera, the USC Rosier School of Education, 1909. Dean Milton Curry, the USC School of Architecture, 1919. Dean Jeffrey Garrett, the USC Marshall School of Business, 1920. Dean Sarah Gellert, the USC Suzanne Dwork Peck School of Social Work, 1920. Dean Elizabeth Daly, the USC School of Cinematic Arts, 1929. Dean Dana Goldman, the USC Sol Price School of Public Policy, 1929. Dean Emily Roxworthy, the USC School of Dramatic Arts, 1945. Dean Willow Bay, the USC Annenberg School for Communication and Journalism, 1971. Dean Pincus Cohen, the USC Leonard Davis School of Gerontology, 1975. Dean William Holder, the USC Leventhal School of Accounting, 1979. Dean Robert Cudietta, the USC Gloria Kaufman School of Dance, 2012. Interim Dean Willow Bay, the USC Ivine and Young Academy, 2013. Dean Anthony Bailey, the USC Bovard College, 2015. And now, please rise for the singing of the national anthem, performed by Madeline Liu, and please remain standing for today's invocation. And gentlemen, please welcome the Dean of Religious Life, Varun Soni.
New Trojans, we gather here today at this auspicious time and this auspicious place for a quintessential academic rite of passage, New Student Convocation. In so many ways, today is the day we've all been waiting for. Not only do we commemorate your formal induction into the Trojan family, but we also celebrate our coming together again as a Trojan family. Since we last gathered on campus, more than 500 days ago, we've all gone through trauma and tragedy. We've all encountered devastation and despair, and we've all wrestled with the emotional impact of doom scrolling and the sheer exhaustion of Zoom fatigue. Indeed, over the course of the pandemic, we've quite literally been left to our own devices. And as a result, we've spent more time speaking with our thumbs than talking with our tongues, more time holding our cell phones than holding our loved ones. And that's why gathering today in person is so significant and means so much. We can never take this for granted again. But the unfortunate reality is that long before COVID-19 cruelly took us away from each other, our cell phones took us away from each other. Long before we put on our physical masks offline, we wore our virtual masks online. And long before we longed to be together, we far too quickly chose our screens instead of each other, and we far too often answered the call of our cell phones instead of the call of the ages. And so, it is within this context and spirit that I ask everyone here today, students, faculty, staff, administrators, trustees, and family members, to join me as you are willing and able in lifting up your cell phones and keeping them raised. It's hard with the robes, I know. It is now my great privilege to offer this blessing of the cell phones. May our cell phones and smart devices be sources of creativity and connection as opposed to outrage and anxiety. May our devices enlighten us to new and different perspectives, worldviews, and realities, and not just amplify and reinforce what we might already think and believe. May we resist the enduring temptation of constantly comparing our real lives and struggles to the curated, idealized Instagram lives of others. May we remember that we don't need hundreds of friends online, we just need three real friends in real life who have our back no matter what. And ultimately, may our cell phones and smart devices empower all of us to bring our gifts of love and service to the altar of humanity. May we recognize once again that we are not isolated beings, but deeply connected in mystery and in miracle to this university, to this community, and to each other. And may we all say together, amen. And now for the moment you've all been waiting for, please be seated.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the 12th president of the University of Southern California, Carol L. Folt.
Thank you, Dean Soni, for your just wonderful, perfect words. That was fantastic. And Madeline Liu for that amazing, uplifting performance. Let's congratulate her again. Here it is. Good morning and welcome to the University of Southern California's 2021 convocation. And a special shout out to all our new Trojans. It is wonderful to be together in person after so long. More than 20,000 students, faculty, staff, and family members are here for this very important and special academic celebration, and to welcome and celebrate students from USC's classes in 2021 and 2020. They're joined by more than 6,000 students who are graduate, master's, PhD, and professional programs from our 22 schools. This is a really big group, and it is so exciting to begin our USC journey together today. You know, I thought about you all as I woke up this morning, and I imagine that you felt something very special when you came here, like I did on my first day. And you probably just felt the spirit of this place, just walking across this beautiful campus like I always do. And it is spectacularly beautiful today. Getting to this point after 18 challenging months of shutdowns and restrictions has not been easy for any of us. The pandemic caused enormous challenges. You faced them with courage and compassion. And now you're here, officially Trojans, thanks to your hard work, your incredible dedication, and the promise of what you're going to achieve ahead. You're the fresh faces of tomorrow. You're going to take this first-rate education that you receive here. You're going to become inspirational doers and thinkers, leaders across the world, just like legions of Trojans have done before you. Now, of course, no one gets here, even to this celebration today, alone. And I'd like to start with words of gratitude. We're here today thanks to so many very special people, including our dedicated landscapers and custodial and essential service colleagues who prepared working round the clock to prepare this gorgeous campus for your return. And to our amazing medical, healthcare, student services, and administrative staff who helped us close, open, reopen safely and securely. And to our extraordinary faculty, our academic and technical staff who adapted almost daily over these long months, and they cannot wait to greet all of you. And of course, to the family, to the friends, to the mentors, the teachers, and all the others along the way who helped you get here. Let's give them a big round of applause. You know, in fact, there are so many people who deserve our thanks today. I just wish I could recognize all of them, but we're carrying them in our hearts. Of course, even as we feel this amazing joy of being together again, we know the pandemic isn't over. And so we need to be vigilant, we need to be careful. That's why earlier this month, I announced rules on testing and vaccination wearing masks, face coverings, to keep ourselves, to keep fellow Trojans, and to keep our neighbors safe. And of course, to comply with LA County public health mandates. Now, I know everybody is tired of these measures, but they are what are keeping us open, and they're keeping us safer. So the benefits far, far outweigh the annoyances. So I thank you all in advance for your cooperation and your understanding. Now I want to talk a little bit, thank you. I'd like to talk a little bit more about you, about our new students. You are an accomplished, motivated, and very passionate group with diverse experiences and backgrounds. Some of you are joining us straight out of high school. Others of you are returning students or graduates pursuing advanced degrees. You include single parents, veterans, transfer students, and staff members seeking advanced degrees. More than a fifth of you are the first in your family to attend college. And another 27% have a family member who went to USC, part of a long Trojan legacy. You come from every state and from 70 countries around the world. You're smart, and this is a very determined group. And you are actually the most diverse and academically talented entering classes in USC's storied history. So congratulations, everybody. All of this and so much more is what makes USC so strong, and it's what makes it a special place. You know, someone once told me that the kinetic energy here is extraordinary. It feels like you're bouncing off the people and growing from the diverse centers of knowledge. I love that imagery. As a scientist, it makes me think of a beaker of water boiling like crazy on a Bunsen burner, fueled by all that energy and all that excitement. And you see that kinetic energy everywhere. You're going to be surrounded by people that are alive with purpose. They're busy, they're smiling, they're determined to be part of something meaningful and something grand. So take a minute right now and just look around this place at your classmates. Yeah, look at them. They are so important for your lives. I want you to meet them, to know them, to support them, because those classmates are going to be your inspiration, and more importantly, they're going to be your support in times of need. And I'm going to tell you a little bit about some of the amazing Trojans from all schools and fields who take that kinetic energy and they make a big mark on society. There's Allison Felix. Class of 2008. I'm sure a lot of you watched the Olympics. She's the most decorated U.S. track and field athlete in history. Allison was part of, get this, USC's amazing group of Olympians who won 21 medals in Tokyo, including more gold medals than any other U.S. university. You know, but for Allison, winning is not defined by all those medals. It's defined by grit, about overcoming defeat, and not letting others impose their expectations on her. It's also about giving back, in her case, by speaking out on vitally important issues like health inequities facing Black women. Trojans also shape our culture as well. This year, 71 alumni and faculty were recently nominated, 71, for Emmy Awards in dozens of categories. It's pretty amazing. And that includes every kind of category, including hit shows like Bridgerton, WandaVision, The Queen's Gambit, shows that are being watched around the world. For more than 140 years, in fact, the people of USC have been serving in the public good. And I want you to know that is a deep, fundamental part of our mission. For instance, over a very short period of time, we distributed more than 230,000 vaccines, saving countless lives right here in Los Angeles. I'm sure that you already know that Trojans share a passion for USC that is legendary. And this passion for USC, it is the real deal, and it unites the entire Trojan family. Being part of this legendary family comes with great responsibility. You have responsibility for your integrity. You have responsibility to treat each other with respect, to be grateful for what is given to you, and to the generations of Trojans who have done so much so that you could thrive here today. Trojans also do not shy away from grand challenges, such as addressing climate change, promoting social justice, redefining, advancing equality and human rights, removing educational disparities. And you're going to meet Trojans who are fighting cancer, creating new industries, and leading in arts and culture in new directions. I am so proud that USC's faculty, staff, students are at the hub of vital discoveries and advances in all of these areas and so many others. And my dream for all of you is to dive right in with them. Finally, I want to leave you with just a couple thoughts as you embark on your USC journey today. First, please believe me when I say that getting to know your professors is the single most important step you can take. Trust me, it is very rare to have access like you have right now to people doing groundbreaking work in virtually every field that is changing the world. And even better, these people are ready and willing and eager to meet you and help you, especially if you take the initiative to get to know them. Second, I want you to reflect today deeply about what it means to be a good neighbor. And I want you to think about this. You need to be very sensitive to the footprint that you leave in our community and in our neighboring communities. I want you to think of our neighbors as our friends. And if you do that, you can build the kind of society we all want to be a part of, one that values respect and diversity, a community of good neighbors and kind and compassionate citizens. Now, finally, I urge you to cultivate something called the beginner's mind. I learned this term recently when I listened to a beautiful audiobook by world-renowned musician Yo-Yo Ma. He says, a beginner's mind is a mind that is open to new questions, to making new connections, and to finding unexpected answers. It's a mindset that allows you to start fresh in life all the time. Yo-Yo Ma approaches every single concert as a new beginning with new, fresh possibilities. Olympian Allison Felix says, when she thinks about running, it is one race at a time. It is not about the arc of her career. She says, I refocus, I regroup, and I get back out there. I just keep fighting. These are such powerful words to remember as you craft your own lives, your own paths here at USC. I hope you will approach each experience with that wonder and excitement that you feel today. Do what you need to refocus and to get back out there when you hit a bump in the road. Your friends, your family, your faculty members, mentors, they're all going to help you. But truthfully, it's your own mindset that will really make the difference. That beginner's mind will help you keep fighting for things that you believe in, to help create the world that you want to create, just, equitable, sustainable world for everyone. So I ask you to think about it. Where is your beginner's mind going to take you in the coming years? What will you stand for? What will you create and discover? How will you stretch yourself to seek new answers to the old questions? All that and so much more is ahead for you. USC is a place of new beginnings and fresh starts every day. It's a place of big dreams and kinetic energy bouncing off people. And it's now a place where you belong, where you're valued, and where we know that you're going to make your own special mark. And I cannot wait to see what that will be. So thank you very much. And now, for the first time officially, get your fingers up and we're gonna shout it out. Fight on!
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome USC's Vice President for Student Affairs, Mr. Winston Crisp.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome home. It is my privilege and great pleasure to introduce two student leaders who will have special words for our incoming students. First, we will hear from the president of our undergraduate student government, Alexis Arreyes. Alexis is a senior in Dornsife, majoring in political science. She cares very deeply about building a better future for our planet and for this community. And she leads college students across the country in sustainability outreach. She and her colleagues in student government continue to work hard at giving undergraduates a voice on our campuses. Also joining us today is our graduate student government president, KJ Queen. KJ is working toward her PhD in biostatistics at Keck. Her research takes a closer look at the cells that protect us against respiratory infections. How timely is that? And deepens our understanding of the immune system. KJ brings this same dedication to her work on behalf of USC's graduate and professional students. Alexis and KJ would both like to share their greetings with our new students as you join this community. Welcome them, and let's hear what they have to say.
Good morning, Trojans, and welcome to the University of Southern California. It is an honor to be here with you today, because today is not just any other day. Today is the day that you will look back on years from now as a seminal moment in your life, one that changes the reference point of when your goals and aspirations went from being a fantasy to becoming a reality. Today is the day that you join the Trojan family. And what a unique time to be taking that leap. Right here, right now, we're all, in many ways, at the center of another new beginning. For the past 18 months, this pandemic has changed the way all businesses, including the business of being a student, are conducted. Virtual is the new normal. Masks and social distancing have become second nature. And even something as universal as a handshake feels foreign. We all have reasons to be concerned. But we have even more reasons to celebrate. And as I look out at Alumni Park this morning, I see thousands of reasons to celebrate. Every one of you brings your own unique set of experiences and perspectives. With your acceptance into USC, you have surmounted a tremendous hurdle, making it through the most selective admission cycles USC has ever seen. Together, you have already achieve something great. So as you take your place here at the University of Southern California, consider the following. Though the path forward may seem unclear, together we find ourselves at a pivotal juncture where we have been gifted the opportunity to start from scratch, where behind us is a foundation that has been built upon years and years of history and tradition. But in front of us lies a new, more unified Trojan spirit waiting to be redefined. So while the future feels uncertain, let your strength and resilience guide you. I cannot think of a better group to help us take on this challenge than you, the newest members of the Trojan family. Thank you.
3 years ago, I walked down San Pablo Street on HSC, slightly lost after picking up my ID and nervous about my first day of graduate school. 3 months prior, I was an undergrad. So what magical transformation did I go through in 90 days to prepare for getting a PhD? Imposter syndrome had reared its ugly head before I even stepped foot in a classroom. We all know that this isn't a unique experience, yet I felt so isolated and like I must be the only one feeling this way. My classmates are incredibly talented, intelligent researchers who are also sincerely empathetic towards the populations that we study. Not to mention the fact that we're being taught by some of the world's best professors. How was I supposed to match up to that? And what did USC see in me that let me be here? 3 years later, and most of the time, I feel competent. I feel confident in my abilities to do research and in my ability to communicate that research to others. I feel confident in my ability to advocate for myself and for my fellow graduate students. But I didn't get here alone, and as people say, it took a village. That trepidation I felt on my first day was met with constant reassurance by faculty that I didn't have to have it all figured out. They encouraged me to not settle for the first opportunity that came around, but instead to search out a mentor who would be the best for me. And that led to a mentoring committee that has shaped me into the scientist I am now. As you start your USC journey, I want to remind you that things might not always be amazing, and that is absolutely normal. There will be tough times, but those are the times for which the opportunity for growth is the largest. Lean on the people around you, lean into the Trojan family, and don't be afraid to ask for help. Look out for yourself and look out for those around you. Plant your roots and don't be afraid to grow. Thank you and fight on.
Thank you, Alexis and KJ, for those inspirational words. Now it's my pleasure to introduce again Michelle Liu, an incoming student at the USC Thornton School of Music. Indeed. Michelle is a talented singer-songwriter who attended the Orange County School of the Arts. Earlier this year, she was named amongst the finalists for the Young Arts Foundation's Voice Awards, joining an accomplished group of vocalists from across the country. At USC, she'll be a part of Thornton's popular music performance program and part of the wider community of incredible, incredible artists on our campus. Today, we will hear her version of Friday I'm in Love by The Cure. Please join me and a warm Trojan welcome to Michelle Liu.
Instead, it's Friday, I'm in love. care about you. It's Friday, I'm in love.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the Provost of the University of Southern California, Charles Zukoski.
So, wow, I'm at SC and I'm in love. What can I say? What can I say? So, that was superb, and Michelle, thank you for that terrific performance. I'm thrilled to welcome all of you here to the Trojan community. I'm sure I'll get to meet many of you during your time here at USC and learn about all the tremendous work you will be doing across the campuses. We can't wait to see what you accomplish. Dream big. Welcome to USC, where you can accomplish those dreams. Now it is my pleasure to welcome back one of our recent USC graduates, Travis Chen. Travis is one of our recent graduates who dreams big and accomplishes much. He joins us to share his experiences and how they play out in the world after graduation. Travis graduated from Dornsife just a few months ago, earning a BA in International Relations, with an emphasis on global business. During his time at USC, he co-founded Sound Mind, a startup that uses music therapy to treat PTSD. And he explores how this technology can help even more people. As his company continues to grow, we also see him helping other businesses collaborate through his work at Amazon Web Services. Not too long ago, he was in your shoes. He was starting his USC programs. Now, Travis is one of the many remarkable Trojan alumni. And his story shows how the knowledge you gain here can guide you towards so many rewarding experiences in life. I hope his words this morning inspire you as you begin your own USC journey. Ladies and gentlemen, Travis Chen.
Good morning, Trojans. My name is Travis Chen, class of 2021, and a proud Trojan. Thank you, President Folt and the Board of Trustees, and of course the USC alumni, for the incredible opportunity to represent USC alumni, recent ones, and ones who've stomped these grounds some years ago, to the incoming class of 2021 and 2020. Just 18 months ago, around mid-March 2020, I was thousands of miles away interning for United States Senator Dianne Feinstein on Capitol Hill in Washington, D.C., when the world shut down. What felt like the beginning of an isolated, lonely time turned out to be one of my favorite memories of being a Trojan. You see, as Trojans, when challenging times dawns upon us, we bond together and unite as one. Very quickly, my friends and I began daily FaceTime and Zoom calls. Organizations turned events online, and professors offered extended office hours just to chat, only because they cared about us, our well-being, and worried about the lost opportunities that COVID-19 would bring. Despite graduating just in May of this year, I'm envious of all of you, that you have the fortune, thanks to science, to be on USC's beautiful campus here at University Park this semester. I reminisce my daily strolls across these very grounds. Alumni Park, runs between classes from Vertita to Sealy Mud Hall in the midst of skateboards, bikes, floods of people, and oddly enough, my times in Levy Library until the early hours of the morning cramming for that final. And of course, not to mention game days, times in the USC Village, and days spent exploring beautiful Los Angeles. I know exactly that feeling some of you are experiencing right now. Some excited, ready to take on these college years ahead of you, but for many of you, I'm sure there's a mix of worry, imposter syndrome, and a sense of questioning, am I really doing enough? But what I can assure you is that as long as you invest the time and energy to meet all those around you, you will build a support system that will guide you, lend you that helping hand, and show you how and where to get to where you want to be, and to tell you that you are doing enough. The relationships that you will build here at the University of Southern California will be pivotal for your success. Like one of my mentors told me during my first semester here at USC, never underestimate the value of the network you're building with your peers. But still, there might be some of you out there that feel like the only goal in college is to get that star internship or to get a high-paying salary. But truthfully, what really matters right now in this moment as you embark on your college career is every single little moment you'll be experiencing as a Trojan living in Los Angeles. So step out of your comfort zones, cherish experiences, and make memories with people around you. Value every single moment that you have with your roommates, classmates, TAs, professors, friends, near and far. Because at the end of the day, these individuals around you will be your rock in life. They will be the ones who will pick you up that FaceTime call when you need it the most, those who will throw a surprise birthday party for you, and those who will visit you after heading off after college, just like many of my friends have for me in Seattle as I began my job just 2 months ago. There might be some of you out there that fall into the easy trap that I fell into when I started here at USC. That is comparing yourselves to others. Coming to USC, there's high expectations, fierce competition, and many times, a certain image of what your life should look like. But what I will tell you is that it's okay to be different. It's totally all right to take your time to figure out your own path, just like how I founded my mental health startup, SoundMind, with my roommate a few years ago. So, Trojans, welcome to the University of Southern California. Enjoy this very moment. This is just the beginning of a very exciting, thrilling, memory-filled experience that you'll never, ever forget. Take care of yourself, your friends, your families, your mental health. Socialize, exercise, find your interests in life, and invest into developing strong relationships with those around you. Stay busy, but manage your time well. And remember, always be kind to those around you. You deserve to be here. You are worthy of being a Trojan. You are a Trojan. Very soon, if you haven't already, you'll be traveling the world and seeing USC around the globe. I've been lucky enough to see fellow USC Trojans at the Harrods department store in London, at the world's largest mall in Dubai, and even at a hole-in-the-wall restaurant in Taiwan, where I was born. It's these small connections that just remind you how small and how close-knit the Trojan family truly is. I am very honored today to be one of the first to welcome you to the lifelong and worldwide Trojan family. And as always, fight on.
Thank you, Travis, for those inspiring words and sharing your experiences. It's now my honor to introduce an acclaimed member of USC's faculty, Professor Anita Dashiell Sparks. Professor,
yes,
I agree. Professor Dashiell Sparks is a seasoned stage performer and theatrical director who joined our School of Dramatic Arts in 2002. She's been a terrific role model and creative coach for students in her acting, movement, and critical studies courses. Through her teaching, Professor Dashiell Sparks helps students embrace empathy as artists and as human beings. She's also helping the wider dramatic arts community take these lessons to heart as the school's Associate Dean for Equity, Diversity, and Inclusion. When you hear her speak, you'll know why her students and colleagues consider her an inventive artist, a caring teacher, and a wonderful mentor. Everyone, please welcome Professor Anita Dashiell Sparks.
Thank you so much, Provost Sikowski, for those warm words of introduction. And good morning, Trojans. It is a privilege to stand before you today and to be able to welcome each and every one of you who are present in this time and space and during this special moment in history into the Trojan family. We are an esteemed community and network that not only spans the globe, but impacts the globe. As a member of this dynamic USC faculty, I want to first say that it is a necessity to see and a privilege to be seen. So first, I want to say to each of you, we see you. I'd also like to offer perhaps a few words of encouragement and inspiration this morning. But more importantly, I want to offer a few words of action. And in this case, they're not actually my words, but they're the words of one of my heroes, zeros, and sheroes, the great poet Nikki Giovanni. In her 1943 poem, A Journey, she said, "I have heard from previous visitors, the road washes out sometimes. I'm not afraid of rough spots or lonely spots. I don't fear the success of this endeavor. I am in a space not to be discovered, but to be invented." A convocation marks the opening of a new chapter, a new beginning, a new possibility in one's life. It is the action of calling people together to assemble in celebration of your entry, your journey into higher education. It is the beginning of your invention and our reinvention. And clearly, we need to be reinvented. The simple action, ability, and freedom for us to assemble today is not lost on me, and it's not something that any of us should take for granted. The past 18 months have reminded us all of that life lesson. And after all we have endured, both personally and collectively, we are forever changed and transformed in such a myriad of ways. We can't unsee what we have seen, nor unknow what we've come to know and understand. And yet here we stand as the epitome of the Trojan, resilient and hopeful, looking forward to what is to come while recognizing and honoring what was and what still remains to be done in the midst of a global pandemic, prioritizing safety, health, and our collective wellness, in the midst of fighting for justice, social injustices all over the world, and fighting for justice in the wake of George Floyd's murder and other lives that have gone too soon. We stand here at the precipice of possibility, reckonings, and reinvention. And as I stand here, I'm reminded of my own ancestors who've come before me and that sacrificed and persevered in the midst of such adversity and in the midst of triumph, so that on my behalf, we could not only exist and live, but that we must endeavor to thrive, not only as individuals, but as a community with the shared commonality of our humanity. So in the spirit of gratitude, I invite each of you to breathe, to take a moment, to take this moment in, and reflect upon all of those in your life, past and present, who have allowed you to reach this milestone and this moment of achievement and possibility. I invite you to say their names, either silently or out loud in recognition, lest we forget. And finally, I leave you with this. As the daughter of an Army general and a proud military family, I'm also reminded today of the words that are etched on the walls of the Korean Memorial in Washington, D.C., which reads, "Freedom is not free." These words tell me that freedom, or the actions of liberation, do not come without responsibility or a cost. As each of us, as each of you embark upon your educational journey at USC, we ask you, how will you use your freedom, your education, your gained knowledge, your passion, your skills, your strengths, to be agents of change, making this world better than how we found it? How will you use your voice to speak truth to power? How will you use your mind to think critically and solve problems? How will you imagine and create art that will heal, inspire, and uplift? How will you empathize, analyze, and debate in order to foster civil dissent and respectful discourse across difference? How will you act or take action? What will you do? USC and the world are waiting to find out. We're waiting to see who you are and what it is that you will contribute to be of value to all. We need your uniqueness, and we invite all of who you are into the process of becoming. Class of 2024 and 2025, what will be your legacy of action and responsibility? How will you use your breath, your life force, your spiritusa, as they say in Latin, to be an inspiration to yourself and to others? We can't wait to see who you are, who you will no doubt become, and what you will do to change and impact the world. We, as USC faculty, staff, and administrators, are here for you and support your growth and development on your journey all along the way at USC. So in this moment of convocation, I charge you to take your place here. Own it. Remember you are here, as Nikki Giovanni suggested, to invent yourself, invent the world you want to see, and to always, always fight on. Thank you.
And now, the dean of each academic unit will offer a special welcome to the scholars being inducted into their respective schools. Please welcome the dean of the USC Dornzeif College of Letters, Arts, and Sciences, Amber Miller.
Thank you. Good morning. Will the inductees to the USC Dornzeif College of Letters, Arts, and Sciences please rise? I'd love to see all those faces. President Folt and Provost Zukowski, I present to you a group of exceptionally talented students who have made the ambitious choice to follow their curiosity. By integrating rich and diverse forms of knowledge, they will forge their own educational path, one that will prepare them to succeed not in a single career, but in every career. Students, I bestow upon you all the rights, responsibilities, and privileges accorded with membership into the University of Southern California Community of Scholars. Congratulations and welcome to the Trojan family.
Please welcome the Dean of the USC Libraries, Catherine Quinlan.
President Folt and Provost Zukowski, on behalf of the faculty and staff of the USC Libraries, I am delighted to welcome all new students to our vibrant intellectual and creative community. Students, we look forward to helping you explore the world through our vast library collections of human knowledge and ingenuity. I wish you many exciting discoveries to come. Welcome to USC, and fight on.
Please welcome the Dean of the USC Roski School of Art and Design, Haven Lynn Kirk.
Will the inductees to the USC Roski School of Art and Design please rise? President Folt and Provost Sikalski, I present to you a gathering of students whose vision of the world we live in sets them apart. With exceptional empathy and creativity, they will produce works of art and design that reflect the beauty and complexity of our world and stand in tribute to a resilient human spirit. Students, I bestow upon you all the rights, responsibilities, and privileges accorded with membership into the University of Southern California Community of Artists Scholars. Welcome to the Trojan family.
Please welcome the Dean of the USC Thornton School of Music and the USC Kauffman School of Dance, Robert Cudietta.
Will the inductees to the USC Thornton School of Music please rise? President Folt and Provost Zukowski, I present to you an ensemble of students who will journey into the depths of the human spirit from prelude to postlude. Using the instruments of their talents and imagination, they'll give us new meanings and melodies to enrich our world. Students, I bestow upon you the rights, responsibilities, and privileges accorded with membership into the University of Southern California Community of Artists Scholars. Bravo, new students, and welcome to the Trojan family. Please be seated. Now, will the inductees to the USC Kauffman School of Dance please rise? President Folt and Provost Zukowski, I present to you a company of students dedicated to expressing themselves in ways that words cannot, from the simplest of gestures to the most mesmerizing expressions of the human body. In doing so, they'll learn to transcend differences in language and culture while capturing our imaginations with their athleticism and their grace. Students, I bestow upon you all the rights, responsibilities, and privileges accorded with membership into the University of Southern California Community of Artists Scholars. Congratulations and welcome to the Trojan family.
Please welcome Interim Dean of the Keck School of Medicine of USC, Stephen Shapiro.
Will the inductees of the Keck School of Medicine of USC please rise? President Folt, Provost Sikalski, I present to you a class of students who will join a vibrant community, a place of dynamic activity in patient care, biomedical research, medical and bioscience education, and community service. We stand at a crossroads in new eras of healthcare and biomedical research. These students will help others lead happier and healthier lives. Students, I bestow upon you all the rights, responsibilities, and privileges accorded with membership into the University of Southern California Community of Scholars. Welcome to the Trojan family.
Please welcome Dean of the USC Gould School of Law, Andrew Guzman.
Will the inductees to the USC Gould School of Law please rise? President Folt and Provost Sikalski, I present to you a group of students who will be instrumental in strengthening our law school as an institution that stands for justice. Together, we will cultivate ethical values based on principles of equity and excellence and support our communities through our commitment to fairness and equality for all people. Students, I bestow upon you all the rights, responsibilities, and privileges accorded with membership in the University of Southern California Community of Scholars. Welcome to USC, and fight on.
Please welcome Dean of the Herman Ostrow School of Dentistry of USC, Avishai Sadan.
While we don't have any undergraduate incoming class, if you're here, please, will the inductees to the Ostrow School of Dentistry, including the programs of occupational therapy, physical therapy, and biokinesiology, please stand up. President Folt and Provost Zukovsky, yes, I present to you a group of students who will provide patients with world-class care in the fields of oral and craniofacial health, occupational science and occupational therapy, and biokinesiology and physical therapy. With extraordinary intellect and profound compassion, they will help us bolster the foundation of wellness in our communities. Students, I bestow upon you all the rights, responsibilities, and privileges with the membership into the University of Southern California Community of Scholars. Congratulations and welcome to the Trojan family.
Please welcome Associate Dean of the USC School of Pharmacy, Daryl Davies.
Will the inductees to the USC School of Pharmacy please rise? President Folt, Provost Zukovsky, I present to you a collection of students who will advance our efforts to redefine pharmacy practice, drug development, pharmacology, pharmaceutical and regulatory science. In our rapidly changing healthcare environment, they will help redefine the role of pharmacists and pharmaceutical scientists in public health and transform the lives of patients everywhere. Students, I bestow upon you all of the rights, responsibilities, and privileges accorded with membership into the University of Southern California Community of Scholars. Welcome to the Trojan family, and fight on.
Please welcome Dean of the USC Viterbi School of Engineering, Yanis Yortzos.
Thank you very much. Will the inductees to the USC Viterbi School of Engineering please rise? President Folt and Provost Zukovsky, I present to you a finite set of students who will use their infinite imagination to develop skills, knowledge, and mindsets to invent the future. These students will produce new technologies as they design innovative solutions to the world's most pressing challenges. And in doing so, they will inspire others with their passion to engineer a better world for all humanity. Students, I bestow upon you all the rights, responsibilities, and privileges accorded with membership into the University of Southern California Community of Scholars. Welcome to the Trojan family and fight on.
Please welcome Dean of the USC Rozier School of Education, Pedro Noguera.
Will the inductees to the USC Rozier School of Education please rise? President Folt, Provost Zukovsky, I present to you a class of students whose mission is to create learning environments where every student can learn. At USC, they'll see how to succeed as educators in any environment. They will prepare the next generation of student mentors while leading their classrooms and their communities with imagination and integrity. Students, I bestow upon you all the rights, responsibilities, and privileges accorded with membership into the University of Southern California Communities of Scholars. Welcome to the Trojan family.
Please welcome Dean of the USC School of Architecture, Milton Curry.
Good morning. Will the amazing inductees to the USC School of Architecture please rise? There they are. President Folt and Provost Zukovsky, I present to you a group of students who will conceive of spaces, structures, landscapes, and environments that are both empowering and inspiring. Through rigorous study and practice, they will rise to meet the challenges of our time while answering a desire to conserve cultural histories and spaces for generations to come. Students, I bestow upon you all the rights, responsibilities, and privileges accorded with membership into the University of Southern California School Community of Scholars. Congratulations and welcome to the Trojan family.
Please welcome Dean of the USC Marshall School of Business, Jeffrey Garrett.
Will the inductees to the USC Marshall School of Business please rise? President Folt, Provost Sikorski, I present to you a gathering of students who will redefine the fast-changing world of global business by harnessing the principles of healthy competition, teamwork, and creativity. These students will strengthen markets around the world, build more inclusive boardrooms, and forge new economic paths with integrity and resolve. Students, I bestow you all the rights, the responsibilities, and privileges accorded with membership into the University of Southern California Community of Scholars. Congratulations, welcome to USC, and welcome to the Trojan family.
Please welcome Dean of the USC Dwork Peck School of Social Work, Sarah Gellert.
Good morning. Will the inductees to the Suzanne Dvorak Peck School of Social Work please rise? President Folt and Provost Sikorski, I present to you a group of students dedicated to improving the well-being of others. They will use science, relationship building, and compassion to help individuals and communities to advance social justice and to eradicate societal problems. And as they do this, their hearts will open to new experiences and new opportunities to serve others. Students, I bestow upon you the rights, responsibilities, and privileges accorded with membership into the University of Southern California Community of Scholars. Welcome to the Trojan family and fight on.
Please welcome Dean of the USC School of Cinematic Arts, Elizabeth Daly.
Will the inductees to the School of Cinematic Arts please rise? President Folt, Provost Sikorski, I present to you a collection of very enthusiastic students with tremendous potential as media scholars and media creators. These students will invite us into new worlds as artists, as storytellers, as game makers, as innovators of new forms of cultural expression. And they will bring their unique perspectives to the screens of the world. In doing so, they will inspire and enlighten. And of course, many of them will entertain us as well. Students, I bestow upon you all the rights, responsibilities, and privileges accorded by membership in the University of Southern California Community of Artists and Scholars. Welcome, welcome to the Trojan family. Congratulations.
Please welcome Dean of the USC Sol Price School of Public Policy, Dana Goldman.
Will the inductees to the USC Price School of Public Policy please rise? That's an impressive cohort. President Folt and Provost Sikorski, I present to you a plurality of Price School and ROTC students who are dedicated in service to all humankind. They will provide compassionate, knowledgeable leadership as they reach across boundaries to design forward-thinking policies and discover innovative policy solutions, making a difference in communities worldwide. Students, I bestow upon you all the rights, responsibilities, and privileges accorded with membership into the University of Southern California Community of Scholars. We can't wait to see what you will accomplish. Fight on.
Please welcome Dean of the USC School of Dramatic Arts, Emily Roxworthy.
Will the inductees to the USC School of Dramatic Arts please rise? President Fultz, Provost Zukoski, I present to you a group of talented and courageous students who will create and perform the stories that show us the many faces of our shared humanity. Through their work, they will allow us to consider our past, examine our present, and imagine our future. Students, I bestow upon you all the rights, responsibilities, and privileges accorded with membership into the University of Southern California Community of Artist Scholars. We wish you all the best and welcome you to the Trojan family.
Please welcome Dean of the USC Annenberg School for Communication and Journalism, Willow Bay.
Will the inductees to the USC Annenberg School for Communication and Journalism please rise? President Folt and Provost Zukoski, I believe we have some breaking news as we present to you a spirited group of students whose passion for global communications will drive the continued transformation of our world. Through their expertise and dedication, with great imagination and intellect, they will keep us all informed, inspired, and connected. Students, I bestow upon you all the rights, responsibilities, and privileges accorded with membership into the University of Southern California Community of Scholars. Welcome all of you to the Trojan family.
Please welcome Dean of the USC Davis School of Gerontology, Pincus Cohen.
Will the inductees to the USC Leonard Davis School of Gerontology please rise? President Folt, Provost Zukoski, I present to you an assembly of students whose compassion and creativity will provide new approaches to successful aging. These students will develop the foresight and the wisdom to understand how an aging population will affect virtually every aspect of our society and deepen our understanding of human health across the lifespan. Students, I bestow upon you all the rights, responsibilities, and privileges accorded with membership into the University of Southern California Community of Scholars. Welcome to the Trojan family, and fight on.
Please welcome Dean of the USC Leventhal School of Accounting, William Holder.
Will the inductees to the USC Leventhal School of Accounting please rise? President Folt and Provost Zukoski, I present to you a collection of students who will work diligently to master the language of commerce. Through careful analysis of financial information, they will develop the knowledge and skills essential to the functioning of our global economy and help bring prosperity to people around the world. Students, I bestow upon you all the rights, responsibilities, and privileges accorded with membership into the University of Southern California Community of Scholars. Welcome to the Trojan family.
Please welcome Interim Dean of the USC Iovine and Young Academy, Willow Bay.
Will the inductees into the USC Iovine and Young Academy please rise? President Folt and Provost Zukoski, I present to you a cohort of students chosen for their ability to re-examine our present and reimagine our future. Together, these students will advance groundbreaking ideas, enterprises, and creative endeavors that embrace technology as informed by culture and invention as guided by the heart. Students, I bestow upon you the rights, responsibilities, and privileges accorded with membership into the USC of Southern California Community of Scholars. We can't wait to see your dreams take flight.
Welcome to the Trojan family.
Please welcome Dean of the USC Bovard College, Anthony Bailey.
Will the inductees to the USC Bovard College please rise? President Folt and Provost Zukoski, I am proud to present a diverse community of online learners, established professionals seeking career advancement who are ready to become influential leaders in their fields. As we celebrate all of our incoming graduate students, we also give a special salute to the many Bovard scholars joining us today. We wish you the best as you pursue your passions with a determined Trojan spirit. Students, I bestow upon you all the rights, responsibilities, and privileges accorded with membership into the University of Southern California Community of Scholars. Welcome to USC and fight on.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome back President Carol L. Folt.
Wow. I liked the competition going on there for how loud we could shout. And I think we're going to do that again, because I want you to thank these incredible deans and the faculties and the staff in these amazing schools you've joined. So just give them one more big hello and thank you. You know, they remind you of the amazing breadth and the diversity and the terrific things that are taking place at our different schools. And to our alumni and our students, you know, those, your words and our faculty speaker, your words and your hopes and aspiration for the future are just beautiful. And you inspire us. And we also know you've lived it. And that means so much. So thank you for all that you said and brought to us today. So the sun is out, students. It is now up to you. It's time that you're going to set out on this incredible, exciting journey at USC. As you know, there's so much that's going to happen along the way. You know the setbacks and the detours for sure, but the successes and the victories, as you know and see, will be there as well. They're going to help shape you, the person you are today, and what you are and what you will accomplish in the future. So I want to say one more time a special thanks to all those parents, teachers, families, and everybody that are sitting out there who have touched the lives of all our students and been their bedrock and support. We welcome all of you, too, into the Trojan family. Your Trojan family cares deeply about everyone here. We're here to guide you. We want to inspire you, to be inspired by you, and to see you realize your incredible potential. Surrounding you is quite an impressive infrastructure of support. And it isn't just the beautiful buildings and the facilities, but it's the people and the spirit, too. And now it is up to each of you to make full use of them. It's a momentous day, a new beginning, fresh start, as I said earlier. So take your deep breath, think about it. This is the time that you're here right now, starting your journey. And this is kind of an amazing thought, but the next time you are probably together with all of these students again will be at your graduation. So a lot is going to happen between now and then. So as you celebrate your new journey, I want you to think also about your responsibilities, those responsibilities to yourselves, to your loved ones, to your fellow Trojans, and to the neighbors and the bigger world that are around us. I want you to wake up every day like I do, feeling filled with gratitude for the opportunities that we've been given to live and learn and grow and serve in this amazing place, to be part of this hub that is USC, filled with that kinetic energy, passion, creativity, and excitement. Now, we end our ceremony with the performance of the alma mater by Armin Akbari, who is a junior studying musical theater at the School of Dramatic Arts. He is going to be accompanied by our fabulous Trojan marching band. And I'd like you all to stand for the singing of the alma mater, and if you know the words, or even if you don't, try to sing along. Fight on, everybody.
Ladies and gentlemen, please remain in your seats until the official party and the students have exited Alumni Park. Students may return their regalia to the designated locations in McCarthy Quad. Thank you.
Sweet.